Family Planning in India, Wikipedia Audio. Family planning in India is based on efforts largely sponsored by the Indian government. From 1965 to 2009, contraceptive usage has more than tripled and the fertility rate has more than halved, but the national fertility rate is still high enough to cause long-term population growth. India adds up to 1 million people to its population every 20 days. Without extensive family planning, India will reach a population of up to 2 billion people by the end of the 21st century. Women in India are not being fully educated on contraception usage and what they are putting in their bodies. From 2005 to 2006, data was collected to indicate only 15.6% of women using contraception in India were informed of all their options and what those options actually do. Contraceptive usage has been rising gradually in India. In 1970, 13% of married women used modern contraceptive methods, which rose to 35% by 1997 and 48% by 2009. Awareness of contraception is near universal among married women in India. However, the vast majority of married Indians reported significant problems in accessing a choice of contraceptive methods. The above table clearly indicates more evidence that the availability of contraceptives problem for people in India. In 2009, 48.4% of married women were estimated to use a contraceptive method. About three-fourths of these were using female sterilization, which is by far the most prevalent birth control method in India. Condoms, at a mere 3%, were the next most prevalent method. Meghalaya, at 20%, had the lowest usage of contraception among all Indian states. Bihar and Uttar Pradesh were the other two states that reported usage below 30%. It is important to note that sterilization is a common practice in India. They also use camps to enforce sterilization. This process can be done with or without consent. In worldview context, the US has also used sterilization. Contraceptive usage. Comparative studies have indicated that increased female literacy is correlated strongly with a decline in fertility. Studies have indicated that female literacy levels are an independent strong predictor of the use of contraception, even when women do not otherwise have economic independence. Female literacy levels in India may be the primary factor that help in population stabilization, but they are improving relatively slowly. A 1990 study estimated that it would take until 2060 for India to achieve universal literacy at the current rate of progress. In 1952, India became the first country in the world to initiate a family planning program. The Ministry of Health and Family Welfare is the government unit responsible for formulating and executing family planning in India. An inverted red triangle is the symbol for family planning health and contraception services in India. In addition to the newly implemented government campaign, improved healthcare facilities, increased education for women, and higher participation among women in the workforce have helped lower fertility rates in many Indian cities. The objectives of the program are positioned towards achieving the goals stated in several policy documents. While India is improving in fertility rates, there are still areas of India that maintain much higher fertility rates. In 2017, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare launched Mission Parivar Vikas, a central family planning initiative. The key strategic focus of this initiative is on improving access to contraceptives through delivering assured services, ensuring commodity security, and accelerating access to high-quality family planning services. Its overall goal is to reduce India's overall fertility rate to 2.1 by the year 2025. Along with that, two contraceptive pills, MPA under Antara program and Chaya, will be made freely available to all government hospitals. Raghunath Chandokar published a Marathi magazine Samaj Swasthya starting from July 1927 until 1953. In it, he continually discussed issues of society's well-being involving population control through use of contraceptives. He explained the use of contraception would help prevent unwanted pregnancies and induced abortions. Carve proposed that the Indian government should take up a population control program, but was met with opposition. Mahatma Gandhi was the main opponent of birth control. His opposition was the result of his belief that self-control is the best contraceptive. However, Periyar's views were strikingly different from that of Gandhi. He saw birth control as a means for women to control their own lives. From the beginning, India's family planning program has been marred by a vertical approach rather than working on additional factors. These factors affecting population growth include poverty, education, public health care. Owing to the foreign aid flowing in for the family planning programs, there has always been a foreign intervention in designing the family planning programs in India without assessing the actual socio-economic conditions of the country. In the early 1970s, Indira Gandhi, Prime Minister of India, had implemented a forced sterilization program, but failed. Officially, men with two children or more had to submit to sterilization, but many unmarried young men, political opponents, and ignorant, poor men were also believed to have been sterilized. This program is still remembered and criticized in India, and is blamed for creating a public aversion to family planning, which hampered government programs for decades. After emergency, the focus of family planning program shifted to women, as sterilizing men proved to be politically expensive. The National Family Planning Program was launched in 1951, and was the world's first governmental population stabilization program. By 1996, the program had been estimated to have averted 16.8 crore births. From 1965 to 1980, family planning in India resulted in a 19.9% decrease in birth rate. This is due in part to government intervention, which established many clinics as well as the enforcement of fines for those who avoided family planning. However, there was high variance between regions in the use of family planning. India suffers from the problem of overpopulation. India's current fertility rate as of 2015 is 2.4 births per woman. A fertility rate of this value drastically increases a population over time. Although the fertility rate in India has been declining, it has not reached the average replacement rate yet. The average replacement rate is 2.1. Replacement rate can be defined as the rate at which the population exactly replaces itself. Factoring in infant mortality, the replacement rate is approximately 2.1 in most industrialized nations and about 2.5 in developing nations. The fertility rates in India have dropped rapidly in rural areas, but are dropping at a stable rate in urban and populated areas. Although this seems promising, two-thirds of India's population resides in rural areas, adding to the decreased fertility rate. Discounting immigration and population momentum effects, a nation that crosses below the replacement rate is on the path to population stabilization and, eventually, population reduction. There have been several factors influencing recent trends in Indian fertility, including, but not limited to, limitation of family planning ability, age at marriage/childbirth, and the space between children born to one woman. Although India is dealing with major overpopulation issues, the fertility rate and the overall population is declining, which is beneficial for not only the overpopulation issues, but also because there is a healthy amount of economic growth due to the populous amount of young workers entering the workforce. Family planning program. The fertility rate in India has been in long-term decline, and more than halved from 1960 to 2009. From 5.7 births per woman in 1966, it declined to 3.3 births per woman by 1997 and 2.7 births per woman in 2009. In 2005, the TFR was listed as 2.9 births per woman. Since this time, the country has recorded a steady decline in order to reach the current rate of 2.3 births per woman. 20 Indian states have dipped below the 2.1 replacement rate level and are no longer contributing to Indian population growth. The total fertility rate of India stands at 2.2 as of 2017. 4 Indian states have fertility rates above 3.5, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Meghalaya, and Nagaland. Of these, Bihar has a fertility rate of 4.0 births per woman, the highest of any Indian state. For detailed state figures and rankings, see Indian states ranking by fertility rate. In 2009, India had a lower estimated fertility rate than Pakistan and Bangladesh, but a higher fertility rate than China, Iran, Myanmar, and Sri Lanka. According to Jin Ronu and colleagues' research and data, they were able to compile enough data to create the following table. India carries a pronatalist attitude towards fertility, with the large family structure creating an environment for new children to learn and grow in Indian culture. Male children are favored over female children, so much so that it is considered among the highest duties of a man, a duty and religious necessity which will bring emotional gratification to the family. Males are raised to be assertive and independent figures, while females are raised to put others before themselves, particularly their family. Families tend to encourage childbearing and expect to provide an environment of support for any new members of the family, raising the children based on Indian family practices and beliefs. Children are not encouraged to be independent or assist the family from an early age, rather the family expects to support and provide for the child until they reach adolescence. Multiple Indian states have adopted a limited two-child policy. The policies are implemented by prohibiting persons with more than two children from serving in government. The most recent policy to be implemented was by Assam in 2017. Some states have repealed policies. Chhattisgarh introduced a policy in 2001 and repealed it in 2005. A criticism of these policies is that it decreases the number of women in government positions, and encourages sex-selective abortions. Historical background. Fertility rate. Historical fertility trend. State and country comparisons. Family in pronatalist India. Two-child policy.